from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. The woman whose decomposed body was discovered in a basement of a Lewiston apartment building Monday night has been identified as 38-year-old Danita Brown of New Gloucester. Detectives were still on the scene today collecting evidence. Police say Brown had been dead for several weeks. Neighbors report a strong odor coming from the apartment house. The man who lived in the apartment above where the body was discovered, 20-year-old Bobby Ryder, was arrested and is being held on an unrelated probation violation. Neighbors say they were familiar with Ryder because that he came into a local diner looking for work. As for the woman,
a lot of fights. I have never seen her or whatnot. I've heard she's been missing for a few weeks, and that's, you know what I know.
An autopsy was performed on the victim's body Wednesday. Officials would not say whether a cause of death was determined. Well, the trial for a man accused of killing his friend in Portland is underway. Dewa Batsidze is charged with murder for the death of Serge Malongo. Prosecutors say Batsidze, whose nickname is Kevin, shot Malongo six times in February 2010 at his apartment off of Park Street. But the defense says the two just got into a fistfight earlier in the day. They say Batsidze was scared and shot Malongo in an act of self-defense. The trial is expected to last a week, and Batsidze himself is expected to testify in his own defense. Now, the small wireless alert system could make a big difference for victims of domestic violence. By squeezing the sides of a pocket-sized device, a wireless signal is dispatched to Westbrook Police. It tells officers that a victim needs help. The Security Against Violence Effort, or SAVE, program was announced in Westbrook today. While there are home alarm systems in cities like Portland, Westbrook will be the first in Maine to have the portable device.
I have to say there's absolutely no guarantees on anything. What we want to do is make sure that victims have options, because a lot of times victims feel like they don't have options.
Now, Westbrook police say they made 120 domestic violence-related arrests last year. First, only about four or five victims will get the panic alarm free of charge, and it's based on a case-by-case situation. However, the security company is committed to as many as needed. Now, several towns in southern Maine are enforcing smoking bans at beaches this summer for the first time. South Portland, Scarborough, and Algonquin all passed ordinances that take effect this year. In Algonquin, parking attendants at the town's main beach lot are handing out cards to remind people that they can no longer smoke on the beach. Town officials in Algonquin say, like other municipalities, their goal is not to have police walking the beaches to monitor things, but to respond and find someone only if they refuse to stop smoking.
Every step of the way is very lenient, and we just hope to have cooperation. And again, so far it's been fantastic. The compliance has been nearly 100%.
More towns, including Old Orchard Beach, are considering banning smoking. Those involved say the bans are meant to curb exposure to secondhand smoke, but also minimize the littering of cigarette butts. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.